As we have been learning about chi-square, I have mentioned a finding called Cramer's V. Cramer's V is the preferred measure of effect size for a chi-square. Cramer's V is a measure of association between two nominal variables. The range of the possible values will be between 0 and positive 1 inclusive. And it should come as no surprise that Cramer's V cannot be negative, because chi-square uses squared values, and the minimum value for a chi-square is 0. Cramer's V is based on the Pearson chi-square statistic, where a positive 1 equals a perfect relationship, and 0 equals no relationship. What makes Cramer's V so useful is that it can be used with various chi-square analyses, from a simple one-way chi-square up to any number of rows and columns. The formula for Cramer's V is the square root of chi-square divided by n times t, where n equals sample size and t equals the smaller of r minus 1 or c minus 1, where r equals the number of rows and c equals the number of columns. However, there is a much more simple formula that you can use for a one-way chi-square, and it is based on another measure called phi. Phi is a Greek letter that rhymes with my and pi and chi. Phi is a measure of association that adjusts the chi-square statistic by the sample size. If you are reporting phi, it should be because you are using a cross-tabulation. The lowest possible value for phi is 0, and the maximum depends upon the dimensions of the cross-tab table. So, for example, for a 3x4 table, you take the smaller of 3 and 4, which is, of course, 3 minus 1. The maximum value, therefore, is 2. You may also see phi-square reported as a measure of association as well. So here is how these three converge. Phi, phi squared, and Cramer's V are actually quite similar. In fact, when there is no relationship between the variables, in other words, when chi square equals 0, then Cramer's V, phi, and phi square will also all equal 0. Now, the formula for phi is much more simple. It is the square root of chi square divided by n. But of course, we want to report Cramer's V because Cramer's V is the preferred measure of effect size for chi-square. The good news is that the output for Cramer's V is similar to phi. And in fact, when you use a one-way chi-square or a 2x2 cross-tabulation, then Cramer's V will equal phi. And you can request Cramer's V in SPSS when you do a chi-square using the crosstabs menu. I have another video about cross-tabulation. Therefore, when you do a one-way or 2x2 chi-square, just use the phi formula, but report it as Cramer's V. This allows you to use the simple formula for reporting effect size. Of course, for a more complex chi-square or cross-tabulation, use the actual Cramer's V formula.